It's a rebroadcast of an interview done with Keys Dan earlier tonight. Well, just a second. Let me get all this started on all the platforms. Here we go. Get that out of the way there. This is a rebroadcast of a podcast that was done earlier tonight with Keys Dan on his podcast, What Makes You Famous, when he interviewed me earlier tonight. So here we go. This can be listened to on Spotify, where it is recorded.
Anchor. What's Anchor? Well, you've been wanting to make a podcast. And Anchor is the easiest way to make a podcast. Anchor gives you everything you need in one place for free. Wait, for free? Which you can use right from your phone or computer. I prefer computer. Creation tools allow you to record and edit your podcast so it sounds great. It does. It really does. They'll distribute your podcast for you so it can be heard everywhere. Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, and many more. You can easily make money from your podcast with no minimum listenership. How is this possible, Anchor? Download the Anchor app or go to anchor.fm to get started. Do it. Do it now. Start a podcast with Anchor.
What radio? The music you want.
What's your host? He's Dan.
What a jerk.
RadioWhat.com.
What's up, party people? It's Keys Dan, RadioWhat.com, DJLittleRock.com, coming to you live in a living color from the Radio What studios. And this is my podcast, What Makes You Famous. It's an extension of the RadioWhat.com internet radio station that I've been running for quite some time. And if you need DJ services, where do you go? DJLittleRock.com. Check availability and get a free price quote. It is easy, I tell you. It is so easy. Maybe you can have little old me at your event. Today on the program, this guy, I've known him for quite some time, but I don't know a lot about him. I just know that he makes me laugh. He makes me smile every time I see him. It's John Rixey, Dr. DP. Yes, we have a doctor coming on the program, the What Makes You Famous program. So, I'm so excited. He has come around to some of my karaoke shows and sang for me, and I've been watching his videos throughout the years. And he comes out with all these lights and makes funny faces, and I'm excited to talk to John Rixey on Dr. DP. I'm sure he got his degree at some point. We'll find out. This week's shows, I have the Old Post Barbecue in Russellville, Arkansas. That's the video dance party, karaoke jam. It's family friendly, so bring everyone. It's a nice after school treat is to come out after you've been working hard all day and your kids have been in school all day. Come out to Russellville at the Old Post Barbecue. Have some good food, some good barbecue. And, if you want some frosty beverages, they do have some. Come on. I do keep it family friendly on the music, but you can imbibe if you want to. It is available. And then on Friday night, I'm over at the Rab in Conway, Arkansas. That's the regular Friday night show. I've been doing that for quite some time now. It feels, on and off for 8 years or so, ever since before that location became the Rab. It was the Conway Supper Club. So come on out and have some fun Friday night at the Rab. They got the full bar, they got the kitchen, the pool tables. They got 10 diamond pool tables, and they have a league that plays pool on Friday nights, but they always keep at least one or two of the tables open if you want to come in and play pool. And then, of course, on the other side of the room, I mean, it's a big place, is the I almost said Conway Supper Club, is the Rab, and it's big. It really is. There's pool tables on one side, and then they keep some tables and the, you know, regular tables to sit at, and the dance floor and the stage. There's a little stage set up, and little old me on the other side of the room playing music for you. And you, yes, you, I'm talking to you. You're the star of the show. It's a karaoke jam, so you can sing a song. You know, you've been singing in the car all day. You've been singing this. That song's been stuck in your head. Might as well grab a microphone and sing it out loud right there at the Rab Friday night. That starts at 8 p.m. So the Old Post Barbecue on Thursday starts at 6 to 9. And then the Friday night at the Rab is from 8 until almost 2 in the morning. So, yeah, come on out. Play with me. And then Saturday, I don't have anything to do. I'm kind of excited about that. Maybe somebody will find something for me to do. If you need a DJ for your last-minute party, give me a call. So without further ado, let's talk to John Rixey. Mr. John Rixey, I know, he's a doctor. Dr. DP. Calling Dr. DP now. John Reeks?
Yeah, it's John Rixey. What's happening?
Dr. DP?
This is Dr. DP. What's up?
Oh, man, it is good to hear you. It's Keys Dan. What makes you famous?
Hey.
Podcast, amongst other things. I realized I've known you for quite some time, but I don't know a lot about you. I'm seeing you in pictures on your Instagram, your Facebook, your YouTube videos. It's kind of crazy. What is a Dr. DP, John Rixey?
It is a combination of everything that has never let me quit and a drive to not give up.
I'm not
never take no for an answer.
Okay. What does that mean? tell me more about Dr. DP, John Rixey.
Dr. DP, well, originally, Dr.
Yes.
DP, everybody wants to know, where does that come from? What does that mean?
Yes.
That originally came from, number one, data processing, because I took computers.
Okay. Where'd
number
you take
two,
them?
I took electronics at Metropolitan. I took radio broadcasting at Metropolitan Votech.
Where's that?
Metropolitan Votech in Little Rock, Arkansas.
Oh, okay. All right. See, I'm not familiar. I just got here. I'm from
okay.
Miami.
Okay.
So you're going to teach me some things, Dr. DP,
okay.
John Rixey.
Yeah. In school, you were able to take, in the early days, in junior high and high school, you were able to take half a day of vocational training.
Yes. I believe I did that. I took electronics half a
right.
day. Yes.
And I wanted to take radio broadcasting, radio and TV broadcasting.
Sweet.
And I had to take introduction to electronics first, because back then in 1978, to be a DJ, to get on the air, you had to have an FCC third class radio telephone license.
Yes, you did. They were just getting rid of them in 86 when I started.
Right, and you didn't have to have the element, the element 9 endorsement, something like that. You didn't have to have the element 9 endorsement or whatever the endorsement was, but you still had to learn it.
Yeah, something like a ham radio license for those of the people that are listening.
Right, you had to know how to calculate the amperage and stuff like that. So it was for the directional radio stations.
Yes. I don't remember Ohm's Law, but I remember there was an Ohm's Law somewhere.
Right. So you had to know all that stuff, but you had to take basic electronics before you could take the radio broadcasting. Right. So I had to take a year of that, and then I got to take the radio broadcasting, which was KLRE, was an actual radio station at Metropolitan.
In Little Rock.
Radios.
Yes.
It's now under UALR.
Okay.
But back then, it was under the Little Rock School District.
Yes. I think I did WKPX, which was in the Broward County School District in Florida, Fort Lauderdale, Florida. And it was a very similar thing where we'd have two turntables and a microphone, and we'd have to learn a little bit about carts. I know how to splice tape.
Right. Back then, we didn't have any of this digital stuff. Back then, when you cut and pasted, this was before computers, people. So the terms cut and paste were actually cut and paste, people.
Get your X-Acto knife out.
Yeah, you used a wax pencil. You actually took a wax pencil, went onto a actual recording tape, and put it down there, and you ran this tape back and forth till you heard the words where you wanted it, put this wax on that tape, and cut it with a razor blade.
Yeah.
And then you actually cut the word. We would record something really stupid.
Sure.
Which was something like, it was a really weird, ridiculous commercial, and it was really long, and then we would cut it down and make it simple, which you see it today. It'll start out with I don't want to plug a company, but it'll be a really long commercial, which is a minute long.
Let's go with widgets.
Widgets. It'll be a minute long widgets commercial, maybe for like a Super Bowl.
Sure.
And you'll see the 60-second long commercial at the Super Bowl, and then as it goes through the year, maybe 6 months later, you'll start seeing a 30-second version of it, and then you'll see a 15-second version,
right,
because they don't want to pay as much. And that's what we would do. We would cut it down to where it still sounds good, and you just cut it out, but we actually did it with the tape.
Oh, yeah.
I liken the
tape cutting to a miter box. You know, say you had a saw and a miter box, except now it's a smaller miter box, and the saw is an X-Acto knife or a razor blade, like you're saying. And yes.
Right.
And then you tape it back together with actual Scotch tape.
Right. And the old-timers that know how to do that are even better at the digital.
Oh, for sure.
We know we can visualize it better.
Right.
So we can actually zoom it up and get down there, and we visualize, and we understand what we're doing better.
Yeah, you know the actual cut and paste.
Right.
Oh, say, so okay, this is 1978, the early days of John Rixey, before he got his doctorate in DPing.
Right.
Yes.
So, and then I like Dr. Pepper, and when it came time for me to DJ on the side and stuff like that, I wanted a spin doctor name, and of course everybody was a spin doctor, so you had to have some type of doctor name. And then
in that time you had Dr. Johnny Fever,
right?
You know, then, he's the hero.
And, you know, Snoop Dogg was around when it came time for me to pick a name, and of course, you know, there was Snoop Dogg, there was NWA, and there was the Dog Pound, and there was a song, BPG.
I think you just jumped forward about 20 years.
I did. That's where the name Dr. DP came from.
We just zoomed forward 20 years to where you picked out the name. So what were you doing in that 20 years? You know,
well,
you learned electronics in 78?
I learned electronics, basic electronics then. I had graduated high school. I had
Where'd you go to high school?
I went to high school at Parkview.
Parkview, and that's in
Little Rock, Arkansas.
Also Little Rock, okay. So you're in Hot Springs now, is that where you're at?
I'm in Hot Springs now.
But you've lived your whole life in the Little Rock area?
Most of my life in the Little Rock area.
Where were you born?
I was born in Ohio.
Ohio. And how did you make the trek from Ohio to Little Rock?
Family brought me down here.
How about that? All right.
Family brought me down here. Most of my family was from Hot Springs, though, so I tracked back to Hot Springs later on in life.
So you still got a lot of people down there, then?
It's where my family's from.
Yeah. All right. So, very good. So, okay. From Ohio, how long did you spend there?
3 months of my life.
3 months, okay. So this is where your mom and dad are from?
No, they had a house there.
Oh, okay. And they are all from the Hot Springs area?
My dad's family's from the Hot Springs area.
Very cool. All right. Learning a little bit about John Reeksy, Mr. Dr. Mm-hmm. DP. And you went to school in Little Rock? How was that?
Went to school in Little Rock. A little shaky.
It's the biggest city in Arkansas, but it's not really all that big in comparison to other cities in America. Maybe a million people right now?
Yeah, it's, Arkansas is not the hugest place in the world. It's Little Rock is a little more active than a lot of places. I mean, it's not like, say, Bryant or even Conway, where places roll up at certain hours of the night.
Correct. You do have some 5 a.m. clubs in Little Rock, so you can walk down the streets, at least the main street and the river market at that time, sure.
Right, that's been in Bryant, or not Bryant, but lived, I spent a lot of time not too long ago living in Blytheville on the air base up there, and they roll their town up about 9 o'clock. So I mean, there's a lot of places in Arkansas, it's just a little after dark, town's shut down.
Yeah, come on in before the street lights come on. Mm-hmm. It's like they're all your mom and dad. Come on.
Right.
So how'd you end up at the Air Force Base?
Me and my wife lived there at a 55 and older community up there.
Sweet.
And it's not a bad place.
Okay. So all right. So you made your way. Okay, after high school, you got go ahead.
After high school, I went to work in law enforcement.
What? He's a cop.
Yeah, I was. Yes, I was.
What town?
I was a law enforcement explorer with Pulaski County Sheriff's Office.
Okay.
I was a teenager.
Yes.
And I went to work at UAMS.
Okay.
As a campus cop.
Okay. All right. That's an important job right there, taking care of people there.
Yeah.
Making sure the kids are safe.
Mm-hmm. And I worked there, got married while I was working there.
Sweet.
Stayed there for, I was there maybe a year and a half. Went from doing that to working across the street at the state hospital.
Okay. Still in the security area or office area?
Actually, I quit doing that and went into healthcare.
Yeah. Okay. I was a security guard when I was 20, and then I went into firefighting and paramedic.
Right.
So I'm seeing some similarities going on.
Right.
I did radio school before that, so and electronics even before that. So wait a minute, are you me?
I have done a lot. I transitioned over to it was like an orderly over there. It was
okay.
A male healthcare worker.
Yeah, dig it.
And
transport.
It was more like an orderly.
Yeah.
It was, we took care of, it's more like an orderly.
In the ER or on the floor or what? the floor. Okay. Do you remember what kind of patients you were taking care of on what floor?
Oh yeah, yeah. It was daily care. It was on 5 upper.
And what kind of patients were they?
They were just regular mental patients.
Mental patients. Okay. Well, I mean, I worked
state,
in ER.
State so. Hospital.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, this was state hospital.
Okay. All right.
State hospital in Little Rock.
Yeah, I could see being an orderly at a state hospital. That can give you some experience.
It was different. I mean, it was okay.
Yeah. I mean, there's different levels of mental health. That you
right.
know, there's some that are very quiet and very introverted, and then there's some that break loose. I saw
right.
quite a few when I was in the hospital myself, working there.
I was there for about a year. And then I left Arkansas. I got divorced.
Oh.
And
where'd you go?
I went to Portland.
Oh.
Portland, Oregon.
Okay. That's a change of pace.
Yeah, I decided to get away and change things up.
Yeah, you went pretty much as far away without getting out of the country, getting out
yeah.
of the mainland or the
yeah.
the lower 48.
Right. So I went up there and I went to a college at it was community college up there.
All right. What'd you study?
Just a little small course to be a CNA.
What's a CNA?
And
accountant? Nurse assistant.
Nurse assistant.
Okay.
Sure.
All right.
Nurse
yeah.
assistant.
I guess there's two CNAs, I think.
Yeah. Yeah. You have to forgive me. I had a skip forward here. I had a stroke on the stage in 2016.
Ooh.
And I have a little bit of mind fog.
Hey, you're doing great, man, John Reeksy. That's
so,
amazing. Okay. So you're in Portland, Oregon.
At Portland, Oregon.
College, learning how to be a nurse assistant.
I was a certified nursing assistant,
uh-huh.
and I worked at Beverly Healthcare up there.
Cool.
For a while, and my mom had gotten to a wreck down here.
Ooh.
So I came back home to sort of help take care of family for a while.
You're a good boy.
And moved back to Alexander, Arkansas.
That's where the family is.
Right.
Okay.
Moved back down here for a while and went to work at some of the hospitals and went to college down here.
More school. Okay.
And that's where I took computer science.
Excellent. You figured at that time computers are starting to take off.
Right. Computers were taking off. That's where I learned how to do the electronic copying, pasting, and all that.
Sure.
And, got the degree in computer engineering.
Okay. And what'd you do with that?
Well, I learned how to do the music computerly.
Yes.
And I built lasers for emerging technology.
Yes.
Helped design and modify the LA-7.
About what year was this? In the 90s? Late 90s?
That was around 94, I think.
Yeah.
It was. Somewhere in the 90s,
I know 99, I gave up my Technique turntables and I went straight
mm-hmm.
computer.
Right.
And started doing some video
yeah.
dance parties and stuff. Yeah.
Yeah, I graduated college in 88.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. And so you were cutting edge, man. And you know,
yeah.
back at that time, people were still using their turntables. And here you are
yeah.
breaking free and starting to use MP3s and WMVs or what, you know, all
yeah,
the like.
Yeah, I was using the, the MP3s and, CMD files for the
yes.
karaoke's and stuff like that.
Oh, you were doing karaoke back at that time.
Mm-hmm.
See, I didn't get into that until probably closer to the 2000s. Yeah, I started getting into karaoke maybe mid 2000s, So you were doing it back then in the 90s. How was that? How's the karaoke scene in Little Rock?
It was crazy.
Yeah.
It was crazy.
How so?
It was a while. I didn't start doing karaoke probably till the 2000s.
Okay. But you were getting the foundation.
I was getting the foundation.
Yeah.
Getting the foundation. I was doing DJing in some of the. I started DJing in some of the strip clubs in Little Rock.
Yep. Okay.
Way back when, like at DL's Darkroom.
Yeah.
You ever heard of that?
No, I haven't.
Way back in the day.
but DJing at strip clubs is a different kind of DJ. It's a lot
of
fun.
Is.
You know, people
it
think
is.
It's seedy, and people think it's strange, but it is a lot of fun.
It is. It's a lot of fun. It's different because you're doing two different jobs at once.
MC and the DJ.
Yeah. And plus you're also backing everybody up. It's crazy.
Yeah, and the girls, you got to make sure you got the girls' music when they're going up there, and you want to make sure that the crowd is happy. You tell a couple of jokes.
And it's not just playing the music, because it's everybody wants their own music. You
right.
play something at the wrong time, and oh my God.
Yeah, they're going to get mad.
It's like romper room, too. It is. It's crazy.
Oh, yeah. The girls got to have their own music. And sometimes they'll bring you the CD. And they'll bring
mm-hmm.
they'll bring you the music, and you just mm-hmm. make sure that you play it when they go up.
And even when they bring you their music, sometimes somebody thinks they own a song.
Yes, that's right. And please, heaven forbid, another girl comes up with the same song. No, mm-hmm. no, there's going to be some tussling in the back room if that happens.
Yeah.
Somebody's going to be speaking to a manager.
Yeah.
So, all right. So, how long did you do the strip club stuff?
Off and on all the time.
Oh, okay.
Off and on all the time, because I worked at clubs here and there. It was I did that. I did some at I helped out at Wix. Some.
What's Wix?
Wix turned into nightlife.
Oh, gee, I didn't even know nightlife. What's nightlife?
That was a university in Asher. It was a major nightclub in Little Rock. That was
okay.
where everybody went when all the other clubs shut down. That was one of the 5 a.m. clubs.
Okay. I mean, I kind of liken it to Discovery right now.
It was the happening place. That's where everybody went when all the other clubs shut down.
Very good. And you were the guy. You were the DJ.
Well, no, I didn't actually work for the club. I just sort of helped out here and there.
Well, good. I mean, hey, it's nice.
I don't
work for Discovery, but I did it one time. That was fun.
Oh, I did too.
Yeah.
Yeah, I worked for Norman Christie Incorporated.
Yeah.
For like 6 months.
Oh, fantastic.
I worked with Cedric.
Oh, that's great.
Worked the front door for 6 months there.
Wow. Okay. So, man, you've been around this town. You've done some caregiving. You've done some DJing. And that's fantastic. So, 94, you're laying down the groundwork. What are you doing for work at this point? Still doing the hospital stuff?
Let's see. 94, I was working security at Best Western in town, and then I went to chief of security, director of security at Hilton Little Rock.
Okay. All right. So security guard, taking care of people
uh-huh.
still.
Right.
It's a pretty good job. Hey, you're making
Managing.
Sure that people are safe. Report. Observe and report.
mm-hmm. Right.
Okay.
Managing the club. It was in there, doing stuff there, yeah.
Fantastic.
Still dealing with the nightclub and stuff like that.
Where do you go from there? What happened next?
I went on disability.
Oh, what happened?
And had a run-in there. I had problems with my back all my life, but I also had a run-in there in Star John Disability in 94.
Yeah.
And it got to be too bad.
Now people always tell me, at least you have your health. Yeah, that's right. A pretty important thing.
Yeah. And I started doing more DJ work.
Okay. Because you're able to sit a little bit.
Right.
It wasn't a stand-up job. It was the sit-down.
Right. And had some back surgery here and there. Tried to go back to work a little bit in 2005. Did some more hospital work, transporter work at the Baptist. 2011, the DJ stuff picked up, started with, 2005, I started doing stuff with, rehab.
What's rehab? Oh,
the group rehab. Somewhere in there, I made a contact with rehab online.
Is that like a rock and roll group?
Yeah, the group rehab.
I guess I don't know them. I'm going to have to look them
up.
Oh, the ones who did the bartender song.
Yeah.
Those guys.
Yeah, Danny Boone Alexander and Dima Jones. I just started, sometimes you see people on Facebook.
Sure.
And it's like, they got a name and it's like, they might be these people, they might not be these people, but they talk funny, and you like the interaction, so you talk to them anyway.
Yeah.
It's like, they may or may not be who they say they are, they may just be fans, but you talk to them because it's good to, the talk is good, the repertoire is good, so we get to talking, and turns out they were who they said they were.
And they were cruising through Arkansas?
Well, they wanted people on a street team, so I joined a street team.
Yeah.
And I started passing out flyers and stuff for them, and got scored some free tickets to their concerts, and met them when they come through. And then they hooked up with Average Joe's Entertainment, which is the label for Coke Ford.
Okay.
And Coke Ford's label put out a deal with DJ KO, who has five star recording, and they started this deal where they wanted DJs to promote their artist, and they wanted their own little group of DJs to start doing remixes.
Okay. And, this is something you were able to do?
Well, I sent in a deal to sign up for it, and Demon Jones backed me on it. In 2011, I got a deal from DJ KO welcoming me in and gave me license to use any and all of their music anytime I wanted to at any of my promotions and any of my shows. So I'm like, sure, why not?
Well, all right. Welcome to the show, John Reeksy, Dr. DP. I like it. Yeah, that's pretty high honor from an entertainer, and even an entertainer company like Average Joe's Entertainment. They're pretty big.
Yeah, and it paid off eventually. I got I got inside and on the back cover of one of the CDs.
Look at you, fantastic! So. How many of the bands did you meet coming through the Arkansas area?
About six or seven.
That's cool. Well, you met Rehab. Did you meet Cole Ford?
I met Cole Ford. I met Rehab.
You mentioned the Low Cash Cowboys? Oh, the Lax dude?
Yeah.
That's great.
There's several of them.
Yeah, I know they do Tyler Farr and Brantley Gilbert over there too, and and Bubba Sparks
yeah,
Montgomery Gentry and those guys. I mean, they're pretty mm-hmm. they're a pretty big big operation out there, and you got to be a part of it. That's great.
Got to sit back and drink with Bubba Sparks once. That was pretty cool. got to drink with Moonshine Bandits. They're pretty cool.
That's pretty cool.
But Demon Jones is by far about the coolest one I got to meet out of all of them. He's laid back. He's really genuine.
Yeah, I mean, that's the great part about being a DJ. Did you do any radio DJing at all?
Just at KLR.
In school, okay. I mean, right. the fun part about being a radio DJ, you don't make a lot of money. I mean, there's a handful, maybe two handfuls of radio DJs that make millions. And most of the time, you know, the fame of being on the radio is what gets you the jobs, you know, maybe like a wedding or a party outside of the radio. That's where you make your money. And the other part is you get to meet these famous people, these entertainers, these people that are actually doing the creating. And it's inspiring. It really is to meet these folks. And you got to you actually got to be a part of it and be a creator. Right. So how did you get into the remixing portion of it? Were you able to parlay the computer work into the remix area?
Oh yeah. They give me the stems. They provided me a whole lot of the stems, the instrumentals of all the stuff that they were coming out with. I got all the original instrumentals, all the original vocals, and I was able to mix them any way I wanted to. I was able to put any soundtracks I wanted to with them, remix them. I would take, intermix them. I would change them up. I did all kinds of crazy stuff with them.
Yeah, that's the fun part, John, is the getting, you get the vocals. That was my favorite part, was getting the dry vocals and then putting a, you know, maybe a techno beat on a country song. And you're like, wow, that's a whole different song. And it's still going along to the same beat. Maybe you up the tempo a little bit. Maybe you cut a part of the song and or a part of the vocals and you put it in this part, or you repeat it several times. That is fun. That is a lot of fun. I mean, what types of genres were you more into? Were you making the dance songs, the rock songs, the pop songs? What were you doing?
Well, I was a little bit different. What I like to do is I like to take two or more beats and mix them together.
Cool. How so?
And I like to take two different beats, mix them together, and come up with a new beat.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, you could drop everything to 128 beats per minute and you know, have maybe like a country twang mixed in with a rock, or what are you saying?
Sometimes I would take an older tune, and another tune, and mix them together. And of course, I would put them to the same beat of the vocals, like the original tune. If it was 128 beats, and the beat I was looking at wasn't 128 beats, I would make it 128 beats.
Yeah.
Bring it to the same key, so everything would be in the same key. I wouldn't mess with the vocal keys.
Okay.
Because then when you do that, it sounds like it's auto-tuned.
Right.
So I would bring the music to the key of the vocals instead of messing with the vocal keys.
That's cool.
I would remaster the music instead of messing with the vocals. I don't like the auto-tune.
Yeah.
So I would remaster the music and then put all the music tracks to the same, and then mix the music tracks to each other, and then put the vocals to it.
Yeah, John Reese. And you were using, now that we have the computer age, the electronic age, it's made it that much simpler, simpler to get your creative juices flowing. You know, if you want to mix those songs together, you could take the two tracks, and I guess you're using Pro Tools or Adobe Audition or something like that, or Cool Edit?
I was using a DJ mixer.
Okay.
One of the DJ stuff is so much easier to use. It's a lot of people don't know how much of the creative tools are actually in some of the DJ stuff.
You mean like the Pioneer? I got the DDJ X2s, I think is what they're called, if I'm not mistaken. But they controlled the MP3s. So you were doing it live and not using some kind of a program?
No, it's not live. I wasn't doing it live. You could probably do it live. I was doing it in a studio setting.
Cool.
But it's a live program.
Neat.
But some of the live programs actually have the capability to do this.
Do you remember what programs they were?
Fog
Serato or
it's like a Serato, but it's actually a DJ program. It starts with DJ.
Virtual DJ or
Virtual DJ.
Yeah, I use virtual DJ. I like that.
Virtual DJ has all these editing features in it.
It does. It really does.
Uh-huh. You can change the keys, you can change the beats, you can do everything with
it. Yeah, I've recorded my sets using it. It's great.
Oh yeah. A lot of people just don't realize how much you can actually do with that software.
Yeah. Oh, it's cool. And you know, people say, well, I try not to use the beat matching too much. I mean, you know, but sometimes pressing that button is kind of easy. I'll spin the CD, the DDJs, and get them matched up.
You don't even have to use the beat matching, but it has a lot of features that are just great.
Yeah, you got your slides to change the pitch of your music, and you can there's different channels that you can put in, especially if you have a controller that is being used in conjunction. So you were, and this is 2004, I guess Atomix, or somewhere in the mid 2000s you were doing this?
Yeah, the software's been out for a long time, and it's always had great tools in it.
Yeah, I had the Atomix before, and then the Virtual DJ shortly after, and then Virtual DJ pretty much bought all of it, and it all became Virtual DJ, so... Yeah,
right.
I mean that was the early days of electronic DJing when I gave up my turntables.
Before that, I was using the Sonic program, the Sony programs.
Okay, I'm not even familiar with those.
Yeah, Sony had some editing programs that were good back then.
That's cool. So you were in. I mean, because I know that Rehab, they had that big song in 2000. Like right in 2000 with the bartender song, so
yeah,
they
had a lot of good stuff back then. I've always been a fan of them. They were great.
That's cool, and it's nice, man. You got in with them and you got to play with their songs. So what did you put out there? Did anything get put up on YouTube or Spotify or anything?
I have some stuff out on my SoundCloud. I have some stuff on. What is it?
I got you on Reverb Nation.
Yeah, Reverb Nation.
Yeah, that's cool. I see your remixes
there.
Right
there. I have a remix of, I have a remix cover that Bubba Sparks does an intro on.
That is neat as can be. Man, see, here you are on the What Makes You Famous, and you are kind of famous, Dr. DP. You've touched it. You've brushed with fame. You've taken care of people doing your medical stuff and doing your security guard work and police work. But, you've also had another side of you, John Rixey. You've done the Dr. DP. So when do you officially feel that you got your doctorate in this? And all the studying is done. You're a doctor now.
It's... I don't know. I don't really feel like I'm anything more than anybody else. It's just, I just never give up. That's why I tell people, just never give up. You can do anything you want to do.
Yeah.
Just don't give in. Don't, no matter how bad you feel at any given time, don't give up. You can do anything you want to do.
Yeah. I mean, and you're
no matter
good
how
bleak
it feels.
You came all the way back from Portland to take care of the fam. I mean, how did your mom fare out?
She did okay. I mean, she's passed away now, but it's all good.
Yeah, but I mean, she had you, man. You took care of the fam. So growing up, how was the family life? What did your dad? What kind of work did your dad do?
He was in the Marine Corps. Uh-huh. You know, he was drafted in the Marine Corps, and then he had a go-kart track and had a business. Had a White Castle business in Missouri. Go-kart track, stuff like that.
Okay, so he dipped his fingers in quite a few pots too. He didn't like to do just one thing.
Yeah, sort of, you know, jack of all trades like me.
Yeah, I like
couldn't really that. Couldn't really settle down to one particular thing.
Yeah, that's where I'm at. I don't like doing just one thing. I like to do a bunch of different things. So what did your mom do?
She was a seamstress.
Seamstress? That's handy.
Yeah, she worked at the state hospital as a seamstress until she retired.
Okay, and that's how you end up getting the job because mom worked there?
Her and my aunt. My aunt was a director at the state hospital.
That's cool. See, it's sometimes it's not what you know, it's who you know.
This is true. This is true.
That's important. So, any brothers and sisters?
I have a lot of brothers and sisters, but I only have one sister in the state.
Oh, okay. All right. Everybody all scattered throughout these United States?
Pretty much.
All right. Well, I mean, you keep in touch still?
Somewhat. You know, Facebook.
Yeah.
That's what Facebook's for.
That's gotten everybody tightened up. All right. So let's get into what is the musical medicine show?
The musical medicine show. That's what the doctor's all about. It's healing through music. I don't profess to heal anything, just make you feel good.
Yeah. Well, I know I giggle whenever I see your videos come across, man. Tell me about those. What got you into making funny videos?
Just, if you can smile, there's so much awful stuff going on. Everybody's trying to make everybody feel bad, especially politics, man. Politics, election year, all this crap. Everybody is at everybody's throat. Your friends always picking at you for this, for that. Nobody wants to be friends with anybody. Nobody wants to tell everybody what they think about any of this. If you can laugh about anything and forget about all that crap, that's what I'm about.
That is beautiful, man. Make them laugh. See, I was thinking maybe it's some kind of clowning that you like to do, or is that part of it?
That's part of it. There's so much going on. If you can take 5 seconds out of the day and laugh, if you can smile and get somebody to think about anything except what's on their mind all day long, one smile can brighten somebody's day. That's all it's about.
Yeah. Man, that's beautiful. You brighten my day too, man. Every time I see one of those videos pop through, I go, what is this all about? This guy, he's nutsy. He's crazy. And here I am saying crazy. And I don't know if that's the right term to use, especially since in a state hospital.
Well, they say all the employees probably belong there.
You know, my first major was psychology. And then I learned very quickly, most psychiatrists need psychiatrists. So, I guess I was heading in the right direction.
Well, they say there's no such thing as normal.
Okay. So, all right. Parlaying. You said you worked in the strip club a little bit. And what is DrDP.com?
DrDP.com now?
Yes.
It's been changed. It was my official website.
Yes.
Now it leads you to my adult toy site.
I see this. Tell me about that. How did you get into this?
I've been selling adult toys for years on the side.
How many years?
Always been probably over 25.
Good. Oh, okay. Now, how do you get into that business? So, is it something that you do like Tupperware, where you invite people over?
Yeah. Yeah, it's just something. Well, we used to do parties years ago.
Okay, I've heard of this.
We used to. Now it's just something that it's this particular deal is like an affiliate thing. It's I send people there and I get a percentage. I don't have to keep anything on stock.
I gotcha. So you say we? Who's we?
Me.
Oh, okay. You know, a lot of times I say we run a radio station online. Uh-huh. Yeah, it's me. Yeah. There, I said it.
I don't have to keep anything on stock. If you go buy something there, you're buying it. I don't see your name. I don't see your credit card. It's all done by the company. I don't handle any of that. But they've been doing that stuff for a long time. They're very, very reputable.
That's neat. I think I have a t-shirt shop like that where I don't keep anything on stock. I just sell the t-shirts online and maybe get a buck every time you buy a shirt.
Right. But I do have regular merchandise though.
Okay.
I've moved my regular website to one of those BIT links.
Okay. What does that mean?
It's a short link. One of those short links. It's bit.ly. Capital DEE, capital PEE.
I think I saw that on your Facebook that you have a bit.ly, I guess. I'm not familiar with what that is, but that's your regular website then?
Yeah, it's because it's the link is so long, I just short linked it.
Okay, and what does that lead you to? Is that the...
That leads you to my total website.
Okay.
But I've got all my regular merchandise there where you can get coffee cups for the 50 Shades of DP. And
what is 50 Shades of DP?
50 Shades of DP is where I stream. I do online streaming where I have music streams, which is like I stream music online where I do where you see the lights in the background, like a nightclub and stuff like that, where I play music and stuff. I do that. Sometimes nightly, where it looks like a little nightclub in the background behind me, and I'll play music, and you can watch me, and you can do that. I do that at various sites, and if you follow me on Instagram, you'll see where I'm doing it.
Yes. Now, I see you have a YouTube page set up at Dr. DP, and you have all your videos up there.
Yeah. Some of those are, a lot of those have been done with you, as a matter of fact.
Yes, I saw that you have one of the karaoke videos up there, you singing. Mm-hmm. I see a few of them now.
As a matter of fact, yes.
Yeah, the one that popped up was the Dirty Deeds Done Dirt Cheap, but you have one that says He Stopped Loving Her Today, and yeah, you singing karaoke. You do have a sweet voice, man, and that was very nice when we met up over there at that Mexican restaurant. And did some karaoke. So are you still into the karaoke scene?
I don't go out and do karaoke on, I don't provide the karaoke service anymore. I do music service on site with the lights like you see when I stream.
Oh yeah.
The karaoke service I might get back into some days. It just got to where it's so competitive, and it's just so hard to keep up with the current music. It's getting easier though.
Yeah.
Some of the services have gotten a lot easier.
Yeah, so I tell people if I have internet, I can buy it right there. I'll buy it for you.
Yeah.
I'm very happy to do that. I mean, I try to keep everything up to date, but every once in a while, somebody will come up and say, "Hey, do you have this song that just came out yesterday? Well, hold on. Let me see if they got it on karaoke. Oh, yes, they do. How about that? There you go. Let me buy it for you. Only a couple bucks. Bam.
Yeah.
And you just made somebody happy.
Yeah. Yeah, it's just so hard to. I'll be honest. I'm too old and too sick to do carry-ins every week.
No,
I just can't. I can't do the carry-ins all the time.
Oh yeah.
I do weddings.
Oh, that's beautiful.
I don't do that many of them. So.
Yeah.
And I'm still a licensed minister, so.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Yeah.
Well, that's good. We're getting different facets of you, John Reeksy. Mr. Dr. DP? I mean, I can't say Mr. He's a doctor. He didn't spend six years in DJ school to be a Mr. Thank you. Dr. DP. So, okay, you are the different facets of you right now. What do you do? You do the DJing, you do the videos. What else?
I'm basically retired.
Okay.
I do online streaming. I online stream at way too many places to actually list. But I do online stream. The place I online stream the most is probably a little heard of place called YouNow. It's just like it's a small community that constantly grows, but
you like it better that way?
It's one of those tight-knit places where people sort of know everybody.
Okay, I can see that.
It's sort of like the modern-day Yahoo.
Okay, yeah, where you got a little chat room type of thing going on.
Yeah, well, they're all sort of like chat rooms. It's the video streaming nowadays is like the old Yahoo. It's like the Wild West again.
Right. I know a lot of the kids are doing these Twitch streamings, playing their video games, and they're making bank. Some of these guys are making some money doing these streaming videos.
I'm not out for the money. Let's face it, I'm a DJ. I'm not out for the money.
Absolutely, man. Absolutely. Being a mobile DJ, it's backbreaking. You know, sometimes it is hard. When I did my first wedding in 86, I got paid $50, but I rented the equipment from Guitar Center for about $75. So I didn't make any money on that one. That was way back then, you know.
I've still got all my equipment, and I'm happy with it, but the more you use it, the more it wears out.
Sure, and it gets expensive to replace it. I know if you make $100, $99 is going to go back in the business. And hopefully that dollar stretches out so you can put a roof over your head and have a little food in your belly.
It is what it is. I tell people I have everything I need right now. I'm doing good. I'm happy just online streaming for fun.
Excellent. That is great. Dr. DP, John Reeksy, getting to know a little bit more about you, man. What else you want to tell the people?
Just like I say, you can do anything you want to do. I've been everywhere I want to be, actually.
Yeah.
And my bucket list is not big.
That's good.
I've completed just about everything I wanted to complete, and I'm happy with that.
So what was on your list? What'd you check off? What'd you do?
Oh, man. Let's see, I've been on a CD. Uh-huh. I've walked into a store and bought a CD with my face on it.
Yes.
Been up on stage, headlined my own concert.
Yes. How'd you feel when you were up on stage in front of all those people?
That was great.
They're all screaming your name, man, and all happy, partially because you're playing music for them.
That was great.
Yeah.
It's great. I mean, there's just so many things that I've wanted to do and actually done. You make a goal, you don't think you'll get there, you concentrate on seeing yourself do it, and then you actually do it, and it just feels great surpassing it.
Yeah. Dream it. It's just be it.
Dream it, see it.
Yeah.
And then be it.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Oh, that's excellent. John Reeksy on the What Makes You Famous podcast. All right, how do they find you online? How do you want the people to connect with you?
All you have to do is type in Dr. DP and multiples will come up. DocTorDeePee.
Yeah. Well, that's definitely a place to find all the links. And what I'll do is on the show notes, I'll make sure I put all your links below, including DrDP.com. In case anybody wants to do some adult shopping.
And the best way to find everything is that bit.ly /DEE PEE. The capital D, small E-E, capital P, small E-E.
Now, I know I saw that somewhere.
Yeah.
I can't find it again, though. I thought it was on your John Rixey page. All right. I'm sure I'll find it, and I'll put it in the show notes for sure. All right. Any last words for the people?
Like I said, my biggest thing I can tell everyone, never let anybody put you down. Well, let me rephrase this.
Okay.
When someone puts you down, don't listen to it. Listen to your heart. Follow your heart. Follow yourself. Don't take harsh words to heart. Believe in yourself. Love yourself. And always be true to yourself. Other people don't mean anything as long as you are true to yourself.
That is a good way to end it, man. Keep the people laughing. Oh,
yeah.
Keep that
always
joy,
smile.
Man. Yeah.
Always smile. At somebody. When you see somebody, just smile at them no matter how they look. Because if you smile, that one smile may change your whole day.
Well, I've been smiling all through this 50 Shades of DP. I love that.
50 Shades of DP. And the whole reason I came up with 50 Shades of DP, the whole story behind that.
Uh-huh.
When I went to this one site to stream, my Dr. DP account had gotten messed up.
Oh.
They would not let me use Dr. DP or connect to Dr. DP, and I had to come up with something other than Dr. DP in front of Dr. DP. And the 50 Shades of Dr. DP was because I liked 50 different styles of music, 50 different ways, and I got all these different kinds of lights around me all the time. And that was the whole thing around the 50 Shades of DP.
Excellent. Dr. DP, John Rixey in the house. Thank you so much, man. Thanks for being a part of this. I appreciate it.
You have a great day, man, and we always enjoy you. And if you guys ever see this man anywhere, anytime, go to one of his shows. His shows are always the best. He always has the best show. And if you ever need any type of anything for your school or your business, he has the very best video show going in the world. He could put a video show together for your business or your school like you have never seen. I promise you.
Thank you, John. Thank you, Dr. DP. I appreciate you so much, man. I'll put this up and I'll send you the links. Thank you so much.
Okay. Have a great day.
And there you go. We broadcast.
People, there you have it. John Rixey, Dr. DP, the musical medicine show. He's good for your soul, baby. Just check him out. Go find him on the YouTube, on, I guess it's the YouServe. I'm not familiar with that one. But if you follow him on Instagram, he will let you know where he's doing his videos. And there's lights, and he's making funny faces. He's playing music. It's a lot of fun. Just give John Rixey, Dr. DP, a follow. It's it's a lot of fun. And man, he's led a life. See, he just like me, he doesn't like to do just one thing. He's been in the medical field. He's done a little bit of law enforcement, security work, and takes care of the people and make people smile. Make them laugh. Are you smiling right now? Come on. Why aren't you smiling? I think most of this podcast, I've been smiling myself, showing my pearlies. I mean, I just happy to be talking to John Rixey, Dr. DP. Thank you so much for being on the program. If you want to tell your story, I encourage you. Give me a call at 501-470-6386 or email info@radiowhat.com. That's it for this edition of What Makes You Famous. KeysDanRadio1.com, DJLittleRock.com. Peace, I'm out of here.
Radio What, the music you want. Hey.
That was a rebroadcast with me and Keys Dan from the podcast interview I did earlier today. And a shout out on YouTube, since this is going over to YouTube, to Mr. Pug, one of my new followers. And I'm going to end this and get this over on YouTube as quick as I can. Thank you everybody for watching. And this has been Triple Cast. Another Triple Cast, actually, on four different networks. I'll be back on in just a little bit. We'll catch all y'all in a little bit. Thank you all for watching.